Have you ever noticed how much glass there is in our cities? Soon it may do more than just let the sun shine in. One day the glass facings around us may power entire buildings or even the whole neighborhood. I'm here with Ghufran Hashmi, an assistant professor in printed electronics. Now, you've been working on some interesting solar cells, things that look a little bit different than what we're used to. Tell me what dye-sensitized solar cells actually are.
The dye-sensitized solar cell is new technology that allows you to create electricity with design and arts and also like the color, as you can see here. This is a dye-sensitized solar cell that was printed on the 10th anniversary of Aalto University.
Yeah, so you can have images, text, absolutely. Logos.
Absolutely, by utilizing all this scalable and printable techniques.
Where can we see this potentially in the future?
Like all the glass surfaces, right from the bus stops to all these skyscrapers and all these kind of modern buildings.
So all the glass that we see in the cityscape could potentially be a source of energy?
Absolutely, absolutely.
And actually it can be a beautiful source of energy too.
Sure, electricity with a look.
Yeah, we could potentially see this on the outside of buildings.
Dye-sensitized solar cells can also be used indoors with this diffuse light.
With light coming in from the window or diffuse from lamps? Light.
Yes, absolutely. We can generate power out of it in order to power up in near future like IoTs and all these kind of nodes.
Solar cells like these can help power a data-driven economy where everyday devices and appliances are connected to the internet. This makes it easier to harvest energy, but is there a simpler way to make solar cells? I'm here with Taina, Lamminmäki, an expert in printing technologies. Now, how is it that you print a solar cell?
Well, we have used two different printing methods. By screen printing, we are applying on the glass different layers, and then we apply with inkjet a perovskite.
And these are technologies that we know from our everyday lives, right?
Yes, they are very familiar. Inkjet in office and home area. And then this screen printing is in textile area. For example, Marimekko is using screen printing in their production.
Yeah, to make these beautiful prints on dresses, shirts, and so on. Yeah.
We can produce different kind of patterns, so the solar cell can look totally different than nowadays.
What about the production? So when you're making these, the kind of special facilities you need, is it different than what we have on the market now?
We can put, for example, in glass production line, one screen printer and one inkjet printer, and then there is the whole production line without any clean room environment.
Yeah, and that's really the key, isn't it? That you don't need a clean room.
Yeah. It will affect to the cost of whole solar cell production.